As of October 31st, 2022, there are 50 volcanoes actively erupting on the planet across 7 continents. In the last week, the Taal volcano produced a series of 42 explosions from its crater lake, marking its most intensive eruptive sequence since March of 2022. Meanwhile, in the Pacific Ocean, the shallow submarine volcano known as the Kaitoku Seamount produced large quantities of discolored water, suggesting that an effusive volcanic eruption might be ongoing. And, in Russia's Kamchatka Peninsula, an unusually large vulcanian explosion was generated from the Bezymianny volcano, scattering a layer of ash to the northeast. For context, the Bezymianny volcano has been near continuously erupting since 1955 after it produced a major plinian and lateral eruption somewhat similar to Mount St. Helens in 1980, causing a large section of the volcano to collapse to the east in a massive debris avalanche. Since then, a large lava dome has grown in its horseshoe-shaped collapse scar. During this period, the volcano has produced intermittent explosions, some of which are quite large, termed vulcanian eruptions, which clear the area above the magma conduit. In addition to frequent pyroclastic flows, this often leads to eruption plumes which reach around 4.5 kilometers or 15,000 feet in height. However, larger eruptions have occurred, such as an explosion which took place on October 23rd, sending a plume of ash to a height of 10 kilometers or 32,800 feet. This was Bezymianny's largest eruption since May 28th. In the Philippines, the Taal volcano has been undergoing a low-intensity eruptive sequence since October 5th. Much like typical eruptive activity at Rincon de la Vieja in Costa Rica, this has consisted of a series of several dozen small magnitude 3 adiabatic explosions from within its succedic crater lake. Last week, 31 such explosions occurred, often producing a visible plume from satellite. The number of explosions further increased this week as 42 explosions occurred between October 25th and October 28th. Oddly, this increased rate of minor eruptions occurred alongside a decrease in volcanic earthquakes and a more dramatic decrease in sulfur dioxide emissions as the volcano is releasing less than 10% of the volume of sulfur dioxide it was on October 20th. While this could indicate that minor eruptive activity might pause for the immediate future, the Taal volcano as a whole is surprisingly difficult to predict and does not tend to follow a predictable pattern. Meanwhile, in the Pacific Ocean, 1,070 kilometers south of Tokyo, a submarine volcano might be producing a new eruption. The volcano in question is called the Kaitoku Seamount, which has a summit at a depth of 95 meters or 312 feet below sea level. Although it has not produced a confirmed eruption after erupting three times between 1984 and 1986, this fact might have recently changed. When submarine volcanoes erupt, it is often difficult to tell that they are unless it produces an eruption plume above the surface or rafts of pumice are produced. However, during more effusive eruptions, one method of identifying if a volcano might be erupting is a dust-colored plume of water coming from the volcano which is visible from satellite, such as seen at the actively erupting Kavachi volcano. Such a plume was detected on October 21st, 22nd, and 23rd from the Kaitoku Seamount. While this could mean that it is erupting, this plume could also be occurring simply due to an increase in gas release at fumaroles or a small landslide at the volcano. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube member Moncator for supporting this channel.